Hello guys, this is Itjustoneguy and I'm back here with another Unity tutorial. And in today's tutorial, what we're going to learn how to do is a boss cam. Now all it's going to be is a mouse look script right here, where we control the character doing a mouse look. And then the closer we get to our boss character, it's going to zoom in. And I'm just going to go in game and show you exactly what I mean. So as you can see here, I have all my mouse look controls right here. It's just a simple mouse look script. And if I get closer, it zooms in to the boss automatically. And the further I get away, the more it zooms out. Now what this could be used for is keeping both of the characters on screen at once. Now the only thing is, if you're going to go real far away, you might want to have it to where you slow down the mouse speed. And if you go real close, you might want to speed up just a little bit. I'm just dealing with the standard mouse speed, which is at. But that wasn't really the purpose of the script, so I didn't set it up. It's just zoom in, zoom out automatically, and get the mouse look controls. Now another thing about this script is, if I go to the script and I add a third character, you can see that the script still works. It keeps all characters on screen, no matter where I am or how far I get away. And we retain the mouse look controls. And that's basically it for how the script works. Now I was inspired to do this by a tutorial I saw on Bracky's channel. He did it in 2D, but I wanted to figure out how to do it in 3D and keep the mouse look controls, and I did. It turns out I didn't need the script for what I was working on, but it's a good bit of information to have, which is why I just put up a video just to help other people if they want to figure out how to do it. Now this can be used for fighting a bunch of enemies, where you just in a confined space and you wanted to keep track of every enemy and keep them on screen, or if you had a boss battle like in a Dark Souls type situation and you just wanted to keep track of the boss inside an enclosed room. Now we're going to go over the variables and just show you how it works. Now these variables right here are just the normal variables found in every mouse look script, so I won't really go over them. But these are the variables I added right here. Now targets is obviously the amount of characters that we want to keep on screen. Right now we have three, but you can have one target in which you will just target the player, and then you can have three targets in which you will keep all three of the targets, or just two, which you will keep track of two. You can have as many as you want basically. The distance is how far away we want the camera to get, so this just keeps track of the actual distance of the camera. And then we have the offset. What I use this for, and you can only set the Y position of the offset, is I'll just show you in game. If that wasn't there, it would basically just zoom in at their feet. Can't really see it with three characters. Let me switch to one, because it's not really going to zoom in that close with three. And you can see the problem right now. And that's why I used the offset, which I'll just set to 1, which makes it the height of the character. Now we have the zoom distance. This is also to keep track of how far away the camera is. And we have the zoom distance offset. Now what the offset does is, if I have three characters and I set the zoom offset to 0, and I go right in the middle of each character, you can see it kind of cuts the characters off. And what we want to do is just add a little bit more distance. and that's all a zoom offset does. It's for solving that specific issue, to add a little bit more distance when we're zooming in on three or more characters. And that's what helps keep every character on screen. Now let's go into Visual Studios and see how the script works. Okay, now we're in Visual Studios, and you can see right here, it's basically all the standard mouse look script variables. You got your X speed, your Y speed, your limiter for the Y, max limiter for the Y, your max limiter for the, your min limiter for the Y, rigid body, X, and Y. The only thing that's different from every other mouse look script is this X position right here is made public, just so we can see it. Now the rest of the stuff is pretty standard except for these two variables right here and some other stuff I changed in update. You can use Unity's mouse look script and modify it to basically do the same thing. Now first we're going to go into this function right here, which I have, which is called get camera focus point. And this is going to get the middle vector 3 between each one of the characters that you want on screen. Now if you have two, it's just going to get the middle point between the two. If you have three characters, it's going to get the middle point between those three characters. And that tells the camera where to focus at, so it can zoom in on that point. Now this basically just says if the target count is 1, which means you only have one target, which would presumably be the player, it's just going to zoom in on the player and act as a regular mouse look script. Now if you have more than one player, we have to create a bounds. A bounds is basically just a box around each one of the players or characters that you want to keep on camera. Now we want to start off with the first character's position, which is target 0. And then we just second position, we just start off as vector 3, 0. Then we create an array of characters, which is the targets right here. And we just go through them. And we use bounds encapsulate, which basically creates a box around each and every one of the targets. So it's just going to go through the targets and add them all into a list and then create the bounds, which includes every target. Now we have our offset, which is the offset we use to make the camera go a little bit higher. So it sets to the height of the player. And as you can see, I set it up right here so it only can go to the height of the player. You can't set the offset for the back and forth or the, what is it, side to side, only the up and down. And right here, the function just returns the vector 3, which is just the center of the bounds, which is the center of the box. The center of the box, the way we set it up, is always going to be the in between all the characters we have that we want to keep track of. And it just says plus the offset, so it's going to be the center of the center of the box plus the offset. And that's what we want the camera to look at. It's basically just going to tell the camera what vector 3 to look at. Now we go here to get zoom distance. This is going to control how far away we want the camera to be. Now this is basically just to get which character is closest, except reverse, so it gets which character is furthest. And everybody should be familiar with this code. The only thing that's different is this is reversed, and instead of distance being mapped out infinity, we set the distance to 0. And essentially, the only thing this function does is get the character that's furthest away. Now, once we have the character that's furthest away, we just go into this code right here, and we get the distance. And we want to use that distance to set where the camera is going to be at. So we make that the zoom distance plus the distance offset, which we use if we want to keep three or more characters on screen, and that sets the zoom distance. And that's all this function does. It gets the furthest character away, and then it sets that as the distance for the camera to be. Now next we're going to go into late update, and I'm going to show you what I changed in that. The first thing we say, if the target count is 0, don't do anything. Because the target count should never be 0, because that means you don't have a target that you want the mouse look to work on. But just in case, we say if the targets are zero, don't do anything. Now if the targets are not zero, the first function we're going to call is get the zoom distance. This will get the distance of how far the camera should be. And we're setting the offset x, which is how far away the camera should be on the x variable. We're setting that zoom to zoom distance. And we're also setting the distance to zoom distance. Now, x is, it's kind of complicated to explain, but x is basically how far you, where you want the camera to be, but it's also the rotation, what is it, the horizontal rotation of the camera. Now normally on a mouse look script it just equals mouse x, but we're adding distance to it to tell the camera how far away we want it to be. And that's all I'm doing right there. And the rest of this is the same exact normal stuff in a normal mouse look script. Except I think I may have changed distance right here. That might have been the only difference. And this function right here, I add get the camera focus point, which tells the camera what to look at. And right here is the normal stuff in a mouse look script. And at the end, I just added transform look at camera focus point. And that tells the camera what to look at. And that's basically it. That's all I changed. It's not really that much. The clamp angle function is in every mouse look script, so just expand the code in case anyone wants to copy it. So you can see everything I wrote. Starting from the top. And that's it for today. Thank you for watching.